Welcome back to the Business Insurance Zone, the talk show that focuses on insurance in your practice. I'm Steve Savant, your host, financial color commentator, interviewer extraordinaire. Oh, yeah. Well, listen, we're just having a ball here. Actually, I think I'm traumatized. I think I'm going through a trauma here because we're talking about women and money. And I just don't remember anybody talking about this in earnest and bringing up the statistics and talking about the psychology and where our culture is going and who has the purse strings, if I may be so punning, who has the purse strings on all this issue.
Right.
Now, when you were talking about, and this blew my mind, I have to say, you know, I've been married to the same girl for 36 years and I have four daughters. You'd think I would have figured this out already, but I guess no. Tell me the skirt story, and I want for all you males, especially you baby boomers, to get ready to become traumatized as I was on this. You can't be serious.
Right.
You're talking about purchasing this skirt.
Right.
Tell me the story again. This is a classic.
Well, oftentimes when, I'm sure when you go to the mall with your daughters and you're shopping for something, how long does it typically take for you to get out of the mall?
I want to get out the moment I arrive.
Yeah. And that's typical of men. What happens is they want to go in, they know what they want, they want to conquer their purchase, and they want to leave.
We want to conquer our purchase?
Yeah.
Is that a psych issue?
They just want to get what they need and get out.
Well, let me tell you, advisors, at the heart of a type A driver emotive advisor, I am a hunter.
Yes. Men are hunters. Now, for a woman, for instance, a simple black skirt sounds simple enough, doesn't it?
Well, to me, like black, I know what the color is and what's your waistline and how long do you want it?
Right. No.
What do you mean no?
There's a lot more to it than just those couple of items. Sure, that's important. But if we were to go shop for, let's say, just a simple black skirt, it could take a few hours. Although there are probably many, many black skirts out there, there's a lot of things that we need to think about when we're shopping for just that black skirt.
Like what?
Like, you know, we might consider, is it too short? How does it look when it's on? Is it too long? Who else wears a black skirt well? Well, maybe, what would work best in heels? Would it go with boots? We might think, what kind of material is it made out of? Is it dry clean? Do I have to go to the dry cleaners? Now, if I have to go to the dry cleaners, that's another stop on my busy list of chores to do. And also, when you think about a dry cleaner, you know, all those chemicals can go into the water, and, you know, what about your children and your children's children, and do you really want to do that?
Whoa. We're thinking that far down the line?
Well, it could be a typical thought process.
Now, you're talking about average woman, or are you talking about, in my terrible testosterone land, that was like high-maintenance woman?
Well, you know, you don't really realize all this is going on, but women are really thinking through their purchase.
Are you conscious of that when you're going through this process?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
I am. And, you know, sometimes that's why there's a disconnect. I think men don't always understand what's going through a woman's mind when they're making a purchase or making a decision. But there is a lot that goes into it. They have to make a connection with their purchase. Mm-hmm. They have to feel really good about their purchase. And you know what? After trying on several black skirts, they may not even leave the mall with one because they'll want to think about it.
Mm-hmm. So if I extrapolate this into financial advisor land, and I am trying to offer a solution that I view as a problem solver,
right?
I probably am not going to sell this on my first interview.
You may not. And that doesn't mean that the woman's not interested in making a purchase. It means that she may want to think about it.
Well, Dr. Barb, is there any code that you could tell us that we could let our male counterparts know that she's interested, just not ready to make the decision so he doesn't completely pack his bags and walk out feeling defeated?
Well, you know, you just have to know a good process. Things to consider when you're going through your typical sales process, there are some steps that you can consider while you're going through that process to give you some signals on as to whether the woman is going to buy or not.
And are these processes that you're talking about, are they fairly universal to all American women?
Well, I can't say they're universal to every single woman in America, no, but I would say generally they will work.
Okay, like for example, now you gave your black skirt, which I'm totally ready never to go to the mall again. I was almost okay with it now that I've been, you know, with my wife now for so long. I was like, I might not just drop her off, I might just go in with her. But now if you told me the process, that was scary to me.
Yeah.
Okay, why do you think that's scary to men, that we're not willing to consider everything that that was a multi-dimensional look at a purchase?
Right.
Are they looking that way on the money issues as well?
Women?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You're kidding.
No, absolutely.
I'm stunned and shocked by what you're saying.
Yeah. Well, women are thinking through the process. They're shopping for more than just themselves oftentimes when they're making a purchase. Because they're thinking, you know, how will this impact me? How will it impact my children? How will it impact the people around me, maybe my parents? You know, when they're purchasing things, they're thinking about all the different people who might also need this service. Mm-hmm. So a lot is going through their mind.
Well, when I'm thinking about being the financial advisor and not the clothier to the female to the female set at large, I'm trying to think of, you know, I pretty much have math on my side. Mm-hmm. I pretty much know how to do a timeline calculation and make a quantitative A plus B equals C calculation.
Right.
And why is that not enough?
Because women don't think that way.
But they're logical.
They're very logical. They just have a lot more going on in the calculation.
So is it true, I've heard rumors to this, is it true that synaptic pathway between the two hemispheres is only a feminine issue, not in the male mindset? I've heard biologically there is no synaptic bridge between the two hemispheres. Well, I don't know if that's true or not.
Know if that's true or not, but you know, in a selling situation, for those people who want to make a sale, they have to understand that women will not follow the same linear process that's in a typical sales process and how typically men would purchase.
I'm thinking of the movie Back to the Future 2.
Yeah.
And Doc Brown is trying to explain the skewing of the timeline.
Yeah.
Do you remember that? Are you saying, I'm here, male advisor, linear timeline. You're saying, we're skewing off here, we're rabbit trailing off here, in my thought process.
Yes.
So the tributary of thought in the feminine mind is branching out into a root system I have no clue about.
Yes, that's right.
I could have saved so many fights in our marriage if I would have just known that. And for all you young people out there freshly married, this could be a marriage counseling session, not a financial advisor. Well, Barb, I'm sorry, but this all takes me aback a bit. You know, I'm taken back that I'm going to have to change my entire way of doing business if I want to land the accounts who have money. And right now, we're saying in our predictions that women are going to rule the next 10 years in the transfer of major wealth to the baby boom. My generation is going to receive it, but it's coming from mom. It's coming from my sister. She's the one that's helping mom out.
Right, right.
So I need to become acclimated to the divine diva diplomacy of a new language that I have yet to learn.
Yeah, and it's well worth the time to listen and learn because it will produce great results.
Well, that's why we're talking with Dr. Barb Provost from Chicago, Illinois. Her main area of expertise is adult learning.
Yes.
And this week, we're even upping Barb's game, kind of stretching her a little bit of elasticity on your personality by talking about a favorite subject. Because when I met you back years ago, when we were both consulting for a company, you were trying to introduce this company to women in finance, and they were open to it, but they didn't really implement it.
No.
And now we're 7-8 years later. If they would have done what you said to do, they would have been the vanguard of this whole issue.
Right.
Well, that's why we believe here at Brokers Alliance, we always want to stay on the cutting edge. What's product, strategies, tactics, the best carriers, do everything we can. And now we're talking about the number one population that has money. Why would I not learn? I feel like I'm going to go to a weekend marriage class, which generally for most guys is death on a platter, right? So, but now we're saying maybe we can get the guys to go to these sessions if we make it an issue of business.
Right.
Wow. Somehow that sounds like an entrapment to me. Well, Dr. Barb, what I'm thinking about, because we're going to be talking about a couple of shows, we've got to have you on here. We're going to stretch this out a couple shows here. When I'm looking at the basic premise of some of the things, I'm kind of sold. And when we go to our next show, we're going to talk about the power of women in the marketplace.
Right.
The power. I'm already aware and I'm awake to, mother has money.
Yes.
And she is terminating her other prior relationships.
Mm-hmm.
In a case that I was on just recently, I cannot believe, and I think I told you this over the phone, where the attorney called me up and he said, Steve, I'd like a little bit more information on the case. I said, be happy to send it to you. I'll be, and I said, so how did you think it went? He says, you were fine. The advisor is not going to be the advisor. And I said, what? He said, my agent is not going to be the advisor. He says, yes. Because in the interview on an estate plan, he spoke only to the guy and never addressed the woman.
Right.
And she felt neglected and looked past and not even worthy of addressing her.
Right.
That they're going to be looking, they like you, they think your contracts and the policies that you're recommending are good, but the advisor himself is probably going to, I said, is there any way to reconcile this? Mm-hmm. Is there any way to save his position? And he says, well, maybe a call and some, you know, kind of basic apology, and which he actually did.
Yeah.
He made the call.
Well, I'm sure there are many times when you've walked away from a sale and you were surprised to find that they didn't purchase and you probably didn't know why.
Right.
And that's because something happened in the sales process that probably didn't strike well with the woman.
All right. So I want to return to this analog thinking here. So I'm on this timeline as an advisor. I'm just going through my chronology, just dutifully patterned male. It's not male pattern baldness. It's male pattern thinking. You know, I'm on this analog timeline going forward. And somewhere in that process, I did not get off the exit ramp when I should have.
Right.
Okay, that's what I'm hearing you say.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I didn't skew. I stayed on point, stayed on task. I kept the logic to myself. And she's still way back there. I think I'm closing, and she's way back.
Well, and that's because you're making the sales process about you and your objective and what you need to do to close the sale.
Mm-hmm.
You're not reframing it to the woman and what she needs to close the sale.
Well, think about this. The phrase framing, remember the old adage? He who frames the argument wins.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to change. Well, actually, I thought I just heard you say, we're not even changing the timeline. We're going to rearrange the entire situation.
Yeah.
This is kind of scary because it's kind of like my wife saying, hey, I want to rearrange the furniture in the house. And I'm like, oh, can I come back later?
Right.
You know, because I'm afraid.
Right.
What's it going to look like? And of course, I can't just and then put it in there. I have to swap it out. I have to change it, move it around.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
But if you want to win in the marketplace, it's going to be worth your time.
Well, are you going to have to show us how to go down this road, Dr. Barb?
Yes, we will.
I want you to know, if you feel pain right now, I am with you. I feel your pain because we do want to serve our clients.
Yes.
And it's our intent to do the best. But if we don't understand the thinking, I don't want to be sitting there all this sweat equity into the interview, and I don't know what I'm doing.
Right.
Well, I got to tell you, I want to thank you, Barb, for being on our show today. We're going to have you on a couple other shows because this is too important to pass over. And remember, you can write us on our email address at thebiz@brokersalliance.com. You can call us at 1-800-290-7226, extension 147, or hop out on our website at www.brokersalliance.com. I'm Steve Savant. You've been listening to the Business Insurance Zone. Well, that's the buzz on the biz for today. Get into the zone, the Business Insurance Zone. We'll see you next time. And when we have Barb on again, we're going to ask her about the powerful impact of women and money.
This has been a Bravo video event of the National Insurance Clearinghouse and Brokers Alliance, one of the largest distributors of insurance products and services to a nationwide network of insurance professionals. You can contact Brokers Alliance at brokersalliance.com or 1-800-290-7226, extension 147.